in carbon fabulous state assessment and data network and their applications to CAP, especially for mathematics education. Today, I'm going to talk about efficiency of item selection in civic CAP based on conjunctive data network modeling after the hierarchy. This is an overview of my presentation. After introduction, I will explain the concept of conjunctive Bayesian network as a cognitive diagnosis model for attribute hierarchy. And I will also explain CVCAP using CVM. After that, by simulation study, I investigate the impact of modeling attribute hierarchy using CVM on the efficiency of item selection method for CVCAP. Finally, I summarize some results and discuss some consequences and suggestions for future research. Cognitive diagnostic assessment aims to determine whether or not examinees have each of many skills or attributes underlying their response to test items. Thus, the ultimate goal of CVCAP is to obtain an accurate estimate for the cognitive attribute pattern of each examinee with fewer items. However, this estimation can be infeasible or impractical if the number of attributes is large. It's because, in general, if the number of attributes that a test measure is k, and if all attributes are discrete with two states, non-mastery and mastery, then the number of possible attribute patterns becomes 2 to the k, and this value increases exponentially as the number of attributes increases. But if we can reduce the space of possible attribute patterns, then the efficiency of attribute pattern estimation and item selection in CVCAP will be improved. And one possible way to do this is to consider hierarchical relationships between attributes. In CVM framework, some researchers suggest to model structural relationship between attributes. Especially, cognitive attributes can be hierarchical, such that some attributes must be acquired before the subsequent ones are mastered. For example, in mathematics, addition must be mastered before multiplication, in that multiplication is really repeated addition. And in this case, we can assume hierarchical relationship between addition and multiplication. Now, let's assume this kind of relationship between A1 and A2, A1, A2, and A3, such that A2 and A3 cannot be mastered unless A1 is mastered. With this attribute structure, the number of possible attribute patterns is reduced from A to 5, because these patterns are impossible. So this type of hierarchical structure between attributes are also called hard prediction. Indeed, various systems for modeling attribute hierarchy have been proposed, such as attribute hierarchy method, hierarchical diagnostic classifying model, DINA with hierarchy, and DINO with hierarchy. And these models also assume hard predicted relationships between attributes. Now, in this study, we introduce conjunctive Bayesian network as another cognitive diagnosis model for attribute hierarchy, and we propose CVCAP using CVM. And then we examine the efficiency of item selection algorithms for CVCAP adopting CVM compared to the CVCAP without modeling attribute hierarchy. Bayesian network is a well-known framework that can be used to model attribute structure. And Bayesian network, also called the Bayesian inference network, is a probabilistic graphical model representing the relationship of a set of random variables using a directed acyclic graph and a set of marginal and conditional probability distributions. This is a simple Bayesian network example consisting of three variables. In the Bayesian Riemann synode V2. Riemann is called the parent of V2, and V2 is called the child of V1. And then we can specify the conditional probability for then a conditional probability distribution can be specified for each node given their parent in the graph. And for the node without parents, like we want in this figure, a marginal probability distribution can be specified. And the convenience of data network comes from the conditional independence implied by the graph. With Bayesian network, the joint probability distribution can be specified as the product of conditional probability distribution of each variable given their parent in the graph. This is an example of Bayesian network that represents a test which measures three attributes with three items. When Bayesian network is employed as a framework for a cognitive diagnosis model, observable variables or item variables are specified as dependent on latent variable, here the attribute variables. And the relationship between attribute variables form a structural model which represents the probability that an examinee has a certain attribute pattern. And the links between attribute variables and observable variables form a measurement model that represents the probability of item responses given attribute pattern. Now let's focus on the structure part of Bayesian network. This graph looks like attribute hierarchy I explained before, right? But the general Bayesian network does not necessarily represent hard predicted relationships. For example, the conditional probabilities of each attribute can be given in this way. Then, the joint distribution of A1, A2, and A3 can be obtained from the specified conditional probability tables, and we can see that all of the joint probabilities are not zero. It means that examinees with all these parents can exist in theory. However, if you assume hard predicted between child and attribute for this graph, mastering child attribute without mastering parent attributes is impossible. Thus, it is natural to set the conditional probability of child variable equals zero given parent variable equals zero as zero here and here. And then it makes the probability of impermissible parents on this attribute hierarchy zero. These three lines. So from now on, we will refer to Bayesian network with hard predicted structures between child attribute and parent attributes like this as conjunctive Bayesian network. The term conjunctive Bayesian networks first appeared in the research by Beer and Winkle et al. In 2007, and they wrote that conjunctive Bayesian networks are specializations of Bayesian network, and the difference being that in the CBN, an event cannot occur until all of its parents have occurred. And they also noted that CBN was introduced in the form of noisy end models in the artificial intelligence literature. Meanwhile, for cognitive diagnosis, we need measurement model for item responses. That is, we need to specify these probabilities as well. two general Bayesian networks. The measurement part of general Bayesian network, not necessarily conjunctive, can be expressed like this way. Four parameters are specified. To reflect the conjunctive assumption of CBN, in this study, we assume the measurement part of CBN as DNR, one of the CBNs that follow a conjunctive rule. Then the conditional probability of items can be represented as follows. In here, GIs means guessing parameters of DNR model, and here SIs indicate thinking parameters of DNR model. Finally, we can represent conjunctive Bayesian network for this example like this. In conjunctive Bayesian network, the relationship between variables are expressed by direct acyclic graph, one in the middle, and conditional probability tables. Here you can hear it. And by the conjunctive assumption of CBN, structural model represent hard predicted, that is, attribute hierarchy, and measurement model follow DNR. This is our concept of CBN for modeling attribute hierarchy. Now I explain how we incorporate CBN for CityCAP. First, for item selection, since the number of possible estimates of attribute pattern for an examinee is reduced, item selection index is now summed over reduced size of attribute patterns, resulting in reduced computational burden. For example, here is the modified PWKL index. This measure is originally summed over all possible attribute patterns, which is up to 2 to the k. Whereas using conjunctive Bayesian network, MPWKL can be modified to be summed for only reduced attribute patterns. Second, for scoring, the process of scoring for estimating an examiner's attribute pattern adopts the late updating method in Bayesian network, since CBN is a specialization of Bayesian network. Then, the probability distribution of joint or marginal probabilities can be used for interim scoring, which is similar to using MAP or EAP estimation for CityCAP. Okay, now let's move on to simulation study. The purpose of simulation study is to examine the impact of learning attribute hierarchy using CBN on the efficiency of item selection method for CityCAP when the attributes are truly hierarchical. Using simulation study, we compare the efficiency of item selection algorithms for CityCAP adopting CBN, that is modeling attribute hierarchy model, and the ordinary CityCAP based on DNR model without modeling attribute hierarchy. We set up two attribute hierarchy structures with 5 and 8 attributes as follows. And the number of possible attribute patterns reduced from 2 to 10 in the first structure and 256 to 26 in the second structure. And for example generation, 1,000 examinees' attribute patterns are randomly sampled from the set of reduced possible attribute patterns according to attribute hierarchy. And for item bank, we considered two conditions of item bank, item quality and cumulative structure. Item split and guessing parameters are randomly sampled from uniform 0.05 to 0.25 for high quality item bank, and from uniform 0.1 to 0.3 for low quality item bank. And two Q matrices of simple and complex structures are considered. And the process of CityCap was simulated for each virtual examinee for each study using each of these seven pattern selection algorithms for CityCap. We considered two termination rules, fixed test max and index of the posterior distribution of attribute patterns. Three fixed test lengths, 5, 10, and 20 items were considered for the first rule, and three min-max values, 0.7, 0.8, and 0.9 were used for the second one. And in fixed length test study, parent-parent classification rate, called PCCR, was used for evaluating the efficiency of CityCap. In variable length test study, mean test lengths were mainly used to evaluate, and other statistics, including minimum, maximum, and standard deviation of test lengths, were also checked. Now I will report the results of the simulation study. First, let's start with the results of the science test study. And these are the graphs of PCCR results of MPWKM algorithm in various conditions. The red line is for CBM modeling, and blue line is for data modeling. And the solid line, the circle, is for high poly item length, and dotted line, the triangle, is for low poly item length. First, we can see that the overall trends are similar regardless of the item length condition. And all these results indicate that the efficiency of item selection in terms of classification accuracy is improved by directory modeling attribute hierarchies using CBM. And the magnitude of improvement is greater when the task measures more attributes here and here. This big magnitude is greater than this. And when the number of attributes is small, the difference of efficiency between CBM and DINA gradually decreases as the task length increases and almost disappeared when the task length is 20. On the other hand, in case of 8 attributes, even when the task length is 20, some difference of efficiency remained in low quality item length. And the trend for adult fixed item selection algorithms were similar to these results, so I skip the slides for them. And we also looked at difference between item selection algorithms. This table shows the PCCR result for 7 item selection algorithms and random selection in low quality item bank, measuring 5 attributes and of task length 10. And especially in the complex Q matrix condition, the PCCR for PWKL and HKL were lower than the other algorithms. And these figures are consistent with the performance in previous researches, and it is known that PWKR and HKL are based on the interim estimate of attribute pattern, but in early stage of testing, these attributes may not be a good point estimate, which decreases the efficiency of algorithms. But the other algorithms do not depend on the interim estimate. And similar tendencies appeared in high attribute conditions, so I'll skip this. And next one is the result of variable length test study. These are the graphs of mean test length results of also glorified PWKL algorithm in various conditions. Orange line is for CBM and blue line is for dynamic. in terms of min task length is improved. And here, sure is a better improved by direct remodeling attribute hierarchies using CDN. And the difference of efficiency between CDN and Dyna was the largest in case of eight attribute and simple Q-matrix structure collision. And we can see that the result of min task length was shorter with complex Q-matrix, this line second column, than with simple Q-matrix, especially in Dyna only. And these tables show the descriptive statistic of task lengths of 25 pk algorithm. When the minmax value 0.8 was applied for termination rule, we can see that the min task length was reduced to roughly 50% to 70% by the modeling attribute hierarchy using CDN. And in the same eigenquality condition, the variance of task lengths was larger in complex Q-matrix conditions with smaller minimum, larger maximum, and larger standard deviation. And averagely, min task lengths was slightly shorter in complex Q-matrix condition than in simple Q-matrix. And also, the trend for adult and selection algorithms were similar to this result as well. And next table is for comparison between algorithms, and it shows that mid test lines of PWKL, NHKL, or Logo than the other algorithms in human complex Q-matrix condition, and this result are similar to PCCL leaders before. And similar tendencies appear in attribute condition, eight attribute conditions at all. In summary, we introduced conjunctive Bayesian network as a cognitive diagnosis model for attribute hierarchy, and we proposed CDCAP using CDN. The results of simulation studies indicated that the efficiency of item selection algorithms for CDCAP was improved by direct remodeling attribute hierarchy using CDN. Specifically, in fixed length test study, the improvement PCCR was greater when the test length was shorter. In variable length test study, the mean test length was reduced by 30 to 50%. And the improvement of efficiency by CDN modeling was greater when the test measures more attributes in those two simulation studies. In our simulation study, we assumed that we know the true attribute hierarchy, but in practice, it is not that easy to find it. The attribute hierarchy is usually specified from expert knowledge experts. But there's always a possibility of some error or misspecification. Thus, we need to further investigate how misspecification of attribute hierarchy affects the efficiency of CDCAP. And in our study, we didn't take any item exposure control method, and we found that any items with higher quality were overused. So we also need to investigate the efficiency when the item selection method are combined with the item exposure control mechanism. Last, an interesting topic for future research would be the development of item selection algorithm considering the unique characteristics of attribute hierarchy or Bayesian network. Okay, thank you for your attention.
Secondly, it seems like the value of necessarily need data from a diagnostic test. You would need data from a real sample of students or people taking a large number of items. So there are lots of large adaptive testing systems in place now. So maybe you should reach out to one of them, or I could hook you up with a couple million response vectors and see what happens. Because I think it has great promise. I don't know, because we're still in the simulation rules. It's hard to tell what's going to happen when you have kind of a larger set of attributes that are kind of messily put together with messy students as well. Anyway, interesting stuff.
Okay, thank you.
I have a little question. So by simulating the
because the result